In this video, we're going to talk about the new credit card money and the new credit. Once upon a time, if you kept your credit score high and you were never late on bills, your credit limits got larger and larger. It was the American way. Today, that is long over the case, and you're about to feel it. You can have an 830 credit score and still have a low credit limit because of your inability to pay. Whereas someone who can have a lesser score.
I've been talking about this for a while. Had a client with very bad credit get a $100,000 unsecured Visa today.
Get way bigger limits. As I'll link to this video, because I talked about this and many people became upset. They became incensed. They became like a little salty because many folks were used to the old credit scoring model, which was to give you more credit based on you keeping your score high and also paying on time. Well, we had something that happened that was called the Great Recession, and this created a lot of review and checking and investigation into you. So we're going to get into that in a minute. But if you're new here, my name is Glendon Cameron. I'm your hustling godfather. What we do here is talk about how to get money through entrepreneurship, through hustling, through online businesses. We talk about how to make money, how to protect money, how to keep money. And for me, the best way to do that is to start a business, primarily through an LLC. I have something for you. Right below the video are a series of free money-making books. They're legit. I want you to go below, download these books, and not only download them, but actually open them and apply the information. Do that for me, and you'll have no problem with what's coming in the future. Do that, and it will literally change the course of your life. Let's get into this wonderful bean footage. We had the Great Recession, and this prompted many financial entities to review your credit. And certain trends begin to emerge. Banks for a long time have known that people have lied about their income on credit applications. But due to many people making their payments on time, paying off their credit card bill, and getting these high limits and maintaining them, it really wasn't a problem. Then the Great Recession happened. Many people who had perfect credit, who didn't have bad spending habits, got laid off, got fired, and it took them months to many years to find another job. This exposed the old credit scoring model because, once again, you know, a lot of good people out there who had no intention of not paying their credit card bill, but month after month after month, you couldn't pay your credit card bill, you had these high limits, so people started living off their credit cards, literally. And a lot of people filed bankruptcy, many bad things happened, so now, the banks have a new game. The banks have a new bag. They're not looking at your score as hard as they're looking at your income. And this is why, in the future, ultra FICO, whatever you want to call it, will be the norm. And there are many people who are like, oh, no, it won't be the norm. It's optional. You're kidding yourself. In 2005 or 6, I started an LLC and I developed a business credit profile. I had $5,000 in the bank. If you know anything about business credit, way back then, if you had $5,000 in the bank, that counted as a credit reference. Today, the number is going to probably be higher for business credit. You're probably going to need $10,000, $20,000, $25,000 in the bank, hence the 5 checking accounts. Get you in the habit of accumulating money and leaving it in the bank. There are many of you who want all your money in the safe deposit box. You don't want to leave any money. You don't want to pay a credit card fee. You just want the most for the least. And I get that, but the rules have changed. You're not going to be able to do those things. And on the personal side, you need to have $1,500 to $5,000 in your bank account. No overdrafts, no bounce checks, none of that stuff. You want your checking account to be pristine and clean because in the future, this is going to have a heavy impact on the credit that you'll be able to get. Here at every man is a millionaire, we are way ahead of everyone else. I made predictions about Bitcoin, Amazon, the social society, and many, many different things that if you go through the archives, you'll see, and they were 2 to 5 years ahead of the event. So the good news here is now you have time to prepare yourself for this, get yourself straight, get your credit straight for what's to come. Do not come at me with like, it's optional. Fool, you don't understand what's coming. What's going to happen and what's going to become the norm is they're going to ask to see more pay stubs. Because, you know, if you have poor credit, this has been the norm. We want to see 3 months bank statements. We want to see 3 months check stubs. And once again, the people who grant credit have become smarter on people lying about their income. So they want to actually see bank statements from the bank. And I guarantee you, it's going to be a point where they're going to want to log into your accounts. That's coming. Now, in the future, for you to get a $35,000 to $100,000 credit limit, you must show that you have the ability to repay that money. American Express has always had what's called an exposure limit. Once you got to a certain point, you had to send in financials for them to raise your credit limit. And if you got to that point and you did not send them those financials, they would cut your credit cards up. They cut you off. I think most people, if you have the income, you can get to maybe a $20,000, $25,000 credit limit. But once again, once you get to 2 or 3 or 4 of those cards, you're going to run into some problems. Now, you have many people who've had credit for decades. This is not going to impact them. If you've had credit for 20 years, 30 years, because once again, the banks know that you're not going to be spendy. You're not just going to be blowing money. So they're not going to mess with you. But if your credit profile is less than 10 years, they will be looking at you. How does one get a higher income to operate and be successful in this new financial environment? Make more money. I know many folks are like, okay, cool, I like that, I can deal with that. And there's some of you who just, for some reason, and it's vanity. You want someone to give you a large credit line based upon a score, regardless of the amount of money you make and whether you have the ability to repay it. Banks, credit card companies are getting much, much smarter, and they're able to scrape information from the internet, scrape information from your Facebook profile, and get a fix on your income level. And you know what's one of the biggest indicators? Your circle of friends. If your circle of friends are all low, have all low income jobs, they're gonna tag you as a low income person regardless of how high your credit score is. Someone else is telling you that. So to protect yourself, there's a few things that you should do. And in my latest video, where the rich people live in Atlanta, a lot of folks are upset. Most of you are very happy. Most of you are inspired. Most of you want to start a business so you can live like that. But there's a few of you who are jelly, and I get that. Look, you're going to have to stop doing the stuff that you're doing. That's just the reality. You're going to have to stop it. You're going to have to change your habits. And one of the reasons that I'm doing that is to show that I am a high income individual. I mean, the house alone, what my mortgage is more money than half of America makes. And if that sounds conceited, so be it, because it's facts. This is my life. I have a big house. I have 2 cars that are paid off. I take trips. And more importantly, every month, I save money. You cannot live at the top of your income and expect to play this game correctly. You will fail. You will lose. So what you got to do is get yourself in the habit of having money in the bank, a credit card that you barely use, and cash money in your wallet. Because what this does is send a reference to your mind that you have money over here, money over here, money over here. And this is where the laws of attraction really kick in. Because when you have the law of action before you have the law of attraction, oh Nelly. So now you start attracting money because you have money. But as long as you stay in that broke state, money is just like, I can't come over here. I can't live here. So you got to learn how to manage money before you make more money. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Let me know your comments below. Once again, be sure to get your free books on how to hustle and how to make money. So with that, I'll see you guys in the next video.